गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू. माय नेम इज डॉक्टर प्रवीण नेरपगा. आई एम फ्रॉम SSVPS डॉक्टर PR गोगरे साइंस कॉलेज धुळे. माय क्वालिफिकेशन इज MSc BEd PhD. सो टुडे आई विल टीच यू अबाउट द रिमेनिंग पार्ट, दैट इज द इनहेरिटेंस एंड वेरिएशन. द रिमेनिंग पार्ट इज बैक क्रॉस, टेस्ट क्रॉस as well as monohybrid ratio. So first I will teach you about the back cross. What is meant by back cross? The back cross is F1 generation cross with the dominant parent is called back cross. In this back cross there are two characters are there, dominant character and recessive character. Dominant where one is a tallness and recessive where one is a dwarfness. These are the parent. So tallness capital TT, dwarfness small TT. From that we get the gametes capital T and small T. Both comes together and they form the F1 generation. That F1 generation is called first filial generation. So in this F1 generation, cross with dominant parent is called back cross. So capital T small T cross with dominant parent, that is the capital TT. They form the gamete, and with the help of checkerboard method, the gametes capital T cross with capital T cross with small t, capital T tallness, and capital T small t tallness. So in F2 generation, all characters we get tall. So that is called the back cross. So in this back cross, significance means it conducts to check the heterozygosity. It requires less time. Using improvement programming, it useful in determining linkage. So that is the back cross. Another, that is the test cross. Explain test cross with suitable example. Test cross is nothing but F1 generation cross with the recessive parent is called test cross. So in the test cross, there are two parents are there, tallness and dwarfness. These are the parent where only as a P1 generation. So tallness capital TT, dwarfness small TT, from that we get the gametes capital T and small t. Both comes together, they form the F1 generation. So this F1 generation cross with recessive parent is called test cross. So in this test cross, capital T small t cross with the recessive parent small t, and from that we get the gametes capital T and small t, and from that we get the small t, and with the help of Punnett checkerboard method, cross it, capital T small t, tallness small t dwarfness, so we get F2 generation. So in F2 generation, 50% homozygous character and 50% heterozygous characters are present. So here we are going to have a test cross. So it have the significance. It is used to determine the homozygosity as well as heterozygosity. And it also useful in plant breeding. So this is called the test cross. So another, that is explain monohybrid ratio with suitable example. Monohybrid ratio, it is also called as 3:1 ratio. 3:1 means what? 3 tall and 1 dwarf. So in this ratio, there are two parents are the tallness and dwarfness. Tallness capital TT, dwarfness small TT. They form the P1 generation. From that we get the gametes capital T and small t. And afterward both comes together, they form the F1 generation. So this F1 generation on selfing means it cross itself. Means F1 generation cross itself. Capital T small t cross with the capital T small t, and from that we get the gametes capital T small t with the help of checkerboard method. Male and female, they cross it, capital T cross with capital T cross with small t, means we get the gametes, that is the capital T tallness, capital T small t tallness, then small t capital T tallness, small t dwarfness in F2 generation. So in F2 generation we get 3 tall and 1 dwarf. So phenotypic characters or ratio, that is the 3:1 ratio, and genotypic ratio is capital TT, capital T small t, small t, small t, 1:2:1 ratio. So that is called the monohybrid. Subscribe it and share it, my videos. At the time of Corona, COVID-19, stay at home, safe at home, protect your life and see my video and watch at the home. Thank you.